Did you hear that? Let me just play that one more time. Well, the hint is that it is something to do with astronomy. If you know what that is, do leave a comment below. So today I just want to share some footage of Venus that I took about a week back or so. As you can see, it is the crescent phase of Venus, and it's pretty bright and big on the scope right now. So I'm using my Astromaster 130, so that's a 5-inch telescope, and I'm using an 8 mm eyepiece over a 3x Barlow. So I think it's almost to the limit of the resolution that my telescope can take. And as you can see, there's a lot of seeing, which is basically the atmospheric disturbance that you see. You can see that it's the way that there's a wave kind of a effect around the planet. So that's basically the atmosphere interfering with what we are seeing. I'm not sure if you noticed this, but if you look at my earlier videos, they are mostly about the planets or the moon passing by. So I would say the Venus passing by, Mars passing by, and so on. And what I want to reveal is the motion that you actually see in those videos. It's actually natural. It's the natural rotation speed of the Earth. In this video, you will see that you can see that Venus is actually staying in focus in a specific spot on the screen. So how I'm doing this is using a motor drive. See, if I switch it off, then you can actually see the planet moving again. Did you see that? So that's just the natural rotation of the Earth that you're seeing that is causing that movement of the planet in the scope area. So what the motor drive does is it compensates for it and moves the scope in the opposite direction in very, very small increments. And this of course works only on an equatorially mounted telescope, because it is just moving the scope in one direction. And if it's an azimuth mount or any other kind of like a Dobsonian mount, you would need to move the scope in two directions to actually get this to work. Anyway, I think I'll delve on that a little late in a later video, and or maybe you could just take a look at all the info that is already available on the net. So guess what? I have one more planet for you. It's Jupiter, and so Jupiter, so these days, is basically high up in the sky early in the morning, and it's west facing balcony, so I can just about see Jupiter like early around 6 o'clock, 5:30, 6 o'clock in the morning. So I managed to get this footage of Jupiter, and it's not really great, but you can work with it. And it's just after sunrise, so you can actually see the blue sky, and because of the sunlight, that scattered light of the sun, you really can't see the moons of Jupiter in this. So it doesn't look like much, but this is where I just want to show you the magic of something called stacking. So just take a look at this stacked image that I have, and just look at that. Just look at the improvement that has on the existing footage. So maybe in one of the next videos, what I will do is I'll show you how that is done, and use some pretty cool free software to do that. And that's it for today. Thanks for watching.